Hey there, everybody. So, I've made a video of me taking apart this optical drive. So this video was filmed a couple or 1 day back or 3 days ago. So after I got done filming the video, what you will see is I took the optical drive apart and I put it back together, and after off camera I've tested the optical drive and some reason it's working again, which funny enough, when this optical drive was in my parents' custom PC build during a movie night, this optical drive I installed in my parents' custom PC showed that it didn't want to work, oddly enough. So, it was acting like something was broken because it was showing up in window. It was acting like it was reading the optical drive, you know, so it reads, and if there was no application accessing this optical drive, the optical drive would go into sleep mode. So that's the behavior it would do. So like I said in the video, I've talked about I had a optical drive in the past that would act like that. I've taken one apart and there was a broken ribbon cable. So that's the one thing I was saying in the video. But this optical drive is really weird. I was kind of shocked that I took it apart, put it back together, and off camera I tested the optical drive and it was working fine. So I don't know what the deal is. So at this point, so what I'm gonna do is, as you can see, I'm gonna install this little video clip at the beginning, so I'm gonna let you watch the rest of it. So just ignore me the talking about the buggy optical drive or what. So, but anyway. Hey there, everybody. In this video, I am going to be taking apart another optical drive. So that's what I'm going to be doing. So if you've been a long time subscriber of the YouTube channel, you probably would remember me taking apart the optical drive, I should say. There we go, get focus. Let's get, okay. And it's a little bit hard to see the camera, see what it's up to. So this optical drive was in my parents' custom PC. And there was one movie night this optical drive would read. Well, it was acting like it was working just fine, but obviously something must have been broken. The last optical drive I took apart, there was a broken ribbon cable that did the same thing. So we're gonna see what is going on. So if you've been a long time subscriber, you probably would remember me taking apart an optical drive. So, but if you're a new subscriber, this is probably gonna be your first time watching me taking apart the optical drive. So this is like a 2008 optical drive, so I was surprised this optical drive decided to act a little weird. So, okay, that was very quick. Okay, let's see what we need to look for. See if I remember how I... Oh, I'll do that. There we go. I guess somebody. I was gonna pause. Let's see here. It's been a long time since I took and bought an optical drive. I'm probably doing something wrong. But let's see here. No. Okay, it should. I'm pretty sure somebody who took in an optical drive apart before, it's probably going this is the wrong direction. My screw is sticking. Okay. There we go. Okay. Well, I don't see no issue. That is weird. Forced optical drive, like I said, if you've been following the YouTube channel, this was broken. And the forced optical drive I took apart, but there is nothing in the optical drive that look obvious that something is broken. Make sure the ribbon cable doesn't look like the broken. This one is in good shape. This ribbon cable is in the good shape. Yeah, okay, so doesn't look like nothing is broken. Okay. So I guess I will. Let's see here. That is so weird. Like I said, I had the optical drive, say, a broken ribbon cable in the past, so that is so strange. I don't know why this unit or this optical drive was weird. Yeah, I'm that's a little bit I'm just a little bit odd about why is it being weird. Okay, well, I guess that's pretty much it, so. That is so weird. Because I was thinking maybe something is broken, but nothing is. There is nothing broken. Come on, there we go. Ooh. Yeah. As you can see. Yeah, still looking to see if there's something I missed, but unless the laser head on this, it's broken. Maybe something is broken. I don't know. Just, it's kind of odd, so. But what I can do is throw it back together. So that shouldn't take me no time to put it back together. I'm just gonna pop this front fissure back in. There we go, that snap back in. I can take the plastic shell and probably shouldn't snap that back in, but no, that's gonna get in the way. Oh, dang it, I saw it, I was October of 2008. Well, at least I got this optical drive for free. I don't know what came out of, or I don't know what PC that came out of. I've done some PC scrapping, or I've done so many PC scrapping in the past, and excuse me, bumping the microphone, so. Get this metal lip under it, so. Yeah, I was hoping I would find something wrong with it, but no, I did not, so. But anyway, you know, if you did enjoy the video, feel free to check out other videos on the YouTube channel if you are interested, so. But if the video, if you don't know how to check out other videos on my YouTube channel, there's different ways. So one of the ways is going into the video notes, and by going into the video notes, there was a link to the video gallery. So if you click that link for that video gallery, you will be redirected. So you can go to that, or you can visit my YouTube homepage, And if you want to go visit that, all you need to do is look at the bottom corner of the video with my profile photo, and next to the profile photo, or my profile photo, should be a... Okay, excuse the camera cutting out when I was saying, when you look at the bottom corner of the video, you should see my profile photo, and next to my profile photo would be my username. So if you click on my username, you'll be redirected over to my homepage. So my homepage would have a playlist and my favorite video I favorite. So then links, so I do have social link. Then I have a PayPal donation button. So if you are interested in my, if you're interested of sending a few bucks to my channel or donate, you will get a shout out, or unless you want to be anonymous. So, but if you do, I don't ask anybody to donate a huge amount, so you can donate a few bucks over to the YouTube channel. So then once you're done checking out other stuff on my YouTube homepage, you can go to the, if you want to visit the video gallery still on my YouTube homepage, just hit the video tab and that will redirect you to the same place like in the link in the video notes. So then if the video caught your interest, feel free to subscribe to the YouTube channel, and subscribe if the video catch your interest. So, and if you did subscribe, if you want to hit the bell for notification, feel free if that bell notification do work for you. So then give the video a like or a dislike, whatever you feel like. And yeah, once you give the video a like or a dislike, check out the video notes below the video. So if you do, click on show more, because if you don't, all you're gonna see is a link to the video gallery. But if you did click on show more, you will see a channel email address. If you need to get in touch with me, Amazon wish list. So if you want to support, you are welcome to support Amazon wish list. And if you did support Amazon wish list, you can be anonymous, or you can have your name out there, whatever shout out you before if you did support the Amazon wish list. So then community detective forms. So if you all sign up with one of those community detective forms, feel free to say hi to me. Hi. Then if you have any positive comment, feel free to post them below the video. And if you have any idea of what the heck is going on with this optical drive, because obviously, as you can see, nothing is physically damaged from the optical drive, so no damage ribbon cable and all that. So if you have any conversation related to optical drive, well, positive conversation of the optical drive, feel free to post it below the video. And I will catch you next time. I will see you later. Yeah.